Let's meet him, shall we? Folks, please welcome to Roots for the first time, Greg Hall.
It is so good to be here. Hey, what's up? It's wonderful to be here. I played in a state last week, and I don't want to tell you the state, but have y'all ever been in a room with people that had more fingers than teeth? That's where I was last week. And I asked the club manager. He had two kids in high school, and I said, I guess they're getting ready for that SAT test. And he said, they don't go to school on Saturdays. And I just went, good God. And well, I'm going to put on my progressive glasses and look at you people. The catalyst for me getting these, I was in Macy's in Green Hills, and I was having a minute and a half conversation with a beautiful woman, and it turned out to be a mannequin. And I just thought she was a good listener. I didn't know. And But I'm getting older, and I don't mind getting older, and I'm glad I grew up with John Wayne and Julie Andrews and Marvin Gaye and the Eagles instead of Kim Kardashian, Maury Povich, Lil Wayne, and Justin Bieber. I grew up in Texas, and grew up in a town called Odessa, Texas. Anyone ever heard of that? Have you? Remember 30 years ago, a little girl fell in a well in Odessa? That's me. And my dad was a pretty hardworking guy, and he used to, when he was trying to give us a work ethic, he would say, work is not a four-letter word, Greg. And I always knew I wanted to put that in a song. And so this first song is, that was the catalyst for it. Well, no one says excuse me anymore. Work's become a four-letter word. We don't say please or thank you or open up a door. No one says excuse me anymore. When I'm sounding like an old cranky man. But I grew up on Floyd and Steely Dan. And I never thought I'd say, are these kids today? No one says excuse me anymore. I recall when I was young, prayers were read and hymns were sung, and that's what we thought church and school were for. But now we put God on a shelf. It's everybody for himself, and the golden rule got swept right out the door. But no one says excuse me anymore. Since Main Street got replaced by the superstore, we're all too busy buying things we can't afford. No one says excuse me anymore. Back in World War II, my grandpa fought on Guam. My neighbor lost his foot in Desert Storm. So excuse me if I ask you, what were they fighting for? No one says excuse me anymore. I recall when I was young, prayers were read and hymns were sung. That's what we thought church and school were for. Somehow we've lost the human touch. We've come so far and lost so much. And I can't help but wonder what's in store. When no one says excuse me anymore. No one says excuse me anymore. Yeah. I don't mind getting older. But I tell you, you know, me television. And by the way, I don't think I'm the only one in the crowd who is wearing progressive glasses tonight. Or who remembers Sears catalog Christmases or Easy Bake Ovens or metal lunch boxes. But I was watching Me Television the other day. That's where they show the old Rockford Files and Hogan's Heroes and all that kind of stuff. And I saw the Brady Bunch. And I remember when I was 11, Marcia Brady was 12, and I had a crush on her. And so I'm watching Me TV the other day, 40 years later, and I got to tell you what, Alice the Maid is starting to... Yeah. starting to feel pretty good about that. The late, great Rich Fagan was a very known and successful songwriter in this town, and he and I wrote this song. And we figured that every man in the world, if he had a conscience, had said at one time, man, I wish I would have been a better guy. Gosh, I wish I could have treated her better and all that kind of stuff. So we, with that as our template, we wrote this. You don't drink anymore, and I don't drink any less. It's not like it was before. Maybe it's all for the best. Well, I know you're ready to leave. I'm not gonna beg you to stay. This time it's not about me, and I won't stand in your way. I'll let you go and hide this hurt with a smile. At least I'm lucky to know you were mine for a while. Someday I'll get it all together, become the man you want me to be. And someday I'll turn my life around, then you'll see. Maybe when I do, someday you'll come back to me. Well, I know you'll be all right. Somehow you've always been strong. I'm finally seeing tonight what a fool I've been all along. And I should have known when we met, I couldn't keep living this way. Love is so much more than a word. It's being willing to change. And it's not easy watching you walk away. And it's too late to do anything but just pray. And someday I'll get it all together, become the man you want to be. And someday I'll turn my life around, then you'll see. And maybe when I do, someday you'll come back to me. Go on and be free. After all you've given me, someday I'll get it all together, become the man you want me to be. And someday I'll turn my life around, then you'll see. Maybe when I do, someday you'll come back to me. Oh, now maybe when I do, someday you'll come back to me. You guys are great. It is a pleasure to be here. There are a couple of folks who are responsible for me being here, and one is Peter Cooper, and one is John Walker, and thank you guys very much for being here. Now, as my buddy Phil Kinsey said, who's coming out here in a little bit, he said, it's going to be tape, Greg. You don't need to play any new songs. So with that in mind, I'm going to play a new song. And you know, I've been doing comedy clubs for a long time, and I had three albums as a songwriter 20 years ago that sold over 9 dozen copies globally. And so I was digging through my catalog, and I found this old thing that wasn't finished, and I tried to finish it in the last couple of weeks, and I liked it because it had some kind of swamp vibe to it or something. So even though it's an old song, it probably has that new mobile home smell all over it. But we'll see. Well, I've cried a river. A broken spirit's got to be strong. I'm pulling an empty wagon on a trip. It's too dang long, but I'll get by. As the sun bakes down on me, I'm gonna get by. Well, I thought this stuff would kill me, but I reckon it ain't my time to die. I can't marry no one, 'cause they ain't you. So I brought the Lord with me to this here cabin in the woods to get by. I keep on changing my thinking, I'm gonna get by. 'Cause I've earned a dozen headstones, and I'm just happy to be alive. Some scars like a hellion do. Now each morning I pray just to do a little good to get by. He's washed me in his grace, so I'll get by. I got one more now or never, so I might as well enjoy the ride. But I feel a good wind blowing, and I'm strapped in and ready to fly. Oh, time goes by so quick. I'll tell you a story. I was self-destructive for a long time, and I'm trying to learn how to get out of God's way. But 15 years ago, I was asked to be the guitar player on a cruise ship. And y'all remember Gordon Lightfoot, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So I'm playing a cruise ship. When the water would get rough, even though the people were safe, I'd start playing the wreck of the Edmund Fitzgerald. And it just... You know, their little wine glasses would be shaking, and I'd go, when supper tame came, the old cook came on deck. He said, fellas, it's too rough to feed you. Excuse me, sir, could you stop? 7 p.m., the main hatchway get in. He said, fellas, it's been good to know you. Hey, Dave, stop playing that church bell chime. It rang 29 times for each man on the Edmund Fitzgerald. Stop it. I'm okay. God, I'll stop. Goodness gracious. I said, I'll play y'all something else. The weather started getting rough. The tiny ship was tossed. Y'all's turn. If not for the courage of the fearless crew, the... Yeah, they told me not to ever do that again. And I had 5 minutes left in my show, so I figured I'd end it with a little class. So I ended with... Near, far, wherever you are, I know that my heart will go on. I'm going to do one more song and get it. Man, I could play here all night. I love this. The late, great Rich Fagan. I was very lucky to know him, and he was a wonderful mentor to me. And this was the last song Rich ever wrote, and I was lucky enough to write it with him. And when you're stumbling through the darkness, feeling lost and all alone, and when the world is on your shoulders, and you're drowning in your pain and loneliness, and you feel like giving up, just remember this. Love is stronger than your fear. Faith is stronger than your doubt. Light is stronger than the darkness. Don't let your light go out. When you're beaten down and broken, or tangled up in your despair, and when you're searching for an answer, you've tried everything but prayer. That's when you need the strength to get down on your knees, and you'll find your miracle if only you believe. Love is stronger than your fear. Faith is stronger than your doubt. Light is stronger than the darkness. Don't let your light go out. It's hard to see heaven when you're staring at the ground. Lay your burden down, and he'll turn it all around. Love is stronger than your fear. Well, faith is stronger than your doubt. Light is stronger than the darkness. Don't let your light go out. Don't let your light. Okay. Oh, you wonderful people. Thank you. Thank you. That cost me a lot of money for that to happen. Bless you. Bless you. I'm going to get some guys on stage right now. We're going to play one more song and get out of here. And this, I'm giving myself a present right now, and I think it'll, I hope it's a present to y'all as well. Guys, get on out here, and I'll introduce you. Mark Sorrells on the piano. Wonderful concert pianist. Hello, brother. Corey Knipp on the drums. Straight from Trace Adkins' band, Mr. Luis Espaillat. There's another guy that's going to come out here in a minute, and this is the reason I'm playing this. This man, remember Al Stewart, Year of the Cat, and Time Passages? 41 years ago, he's the guy who wrote the sax for Year of the Cat and Time Passages and played on Al Stewart's album. He also played on every Rod Stewart album, The Eagles' Long Run, George Harrison's All Things Must Pass, David Bowie, Diamond Dogs. Oh, you're out here already, aren't you, Phil? Mr. Phil Kenzie on the saxophone. And oh, and by the way, these guys never met. This is a testimony to how good these guys are. Oh, by the way, Luis, Phil, Phil, Corey, and Mr. Sorrells, will you... Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Music City Roots. Good night.
All right, let's hear it for Greg Hall, everybody. Greg, that was great, man.